We have our heading.
Here we go!
From the magic within our hearts to the adventure beyond the horizon, there is only one Disney.
This Disney DVD is enhanced with Disney's Fast Play. Your movie and a selection of bonus features will begin automatically. To bypass Fast Play, select the main menu button at any time. Fast Play will begin in a moment.
What's going on here?
Little puppet made of pine, wait.
I can move.
Oh, look, Father, look!
Well, it's about time!
Hello?
Penny, I don't have much time.
Daddy?
I don't understand.
It's okay, Penny. You have Bolt.
I've altered him.
He can protect you now.
Bolt, speak.
Get that dog!
Nice move.
The star of the biggest show in Hollywood.
She's still in danger.
The only problem is...
Hold on, Penny.
He thinks it's all real.
Don't let him out. He's never been off the set before.
I'm coming, Penny.
Production of the hit television show Bolt shut down today when its star dog went missing.
Oh.
You look familiar.
What?
Yeah, he's real good with the faces and such.
I gotta remember. It's gonna kill me. Hold on. No, I don't know. I thought I knew.
I need someone close to the green-eyed man. A cat.
Wow, it's a good knot. Were you in the Navy?
Well, I'll release you, cat, when we find Penny.
Slow down! You're scraping the fur off my...
You must be so scared.
Bolt's not scared of anything.
You're Bolt the super dog!
Where's Penny? She was kidnapped by the green-eyed man, but I've captured this cat. She's taking me to Penny.
I can be a valuable addition to your team.
The road will be rough.
I have a ball.
Easy won't be part of the equation.
Promise.
Danger at every turn.
I eat danger for breakfast.
You hungry?
Starving.
This Thanksgiving.
How do you say no way I'm doing this in crazy?
Let it begin.
One unlikely team.
Look, genius, you're not a super dog.
Is on a mission to get back home.
He can be anywhere by now.
This is awesome!
And the comedy event of the holiday season...
Bolt!
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 ...is about to be unleashed.
Super Bar! Super Bar!
We need a fast set of wheels.
I'll get my ball.
Bolt.
As fairies bring autumn to the world, a new adventure arrives. Legend tells of a precious moonstone, the most powerful source of magic in Pixie Hollow. But now, this great force is in danger. And with the help of her friends, Tinkerbell's quest will begin. Go beyond Pixie Hollow and discover Tinkerbell and the Lost Treasure. Coming soon to Disney DVD and Blu-ray.
In the history of space exploration, a daring story is about to be told of five extraordinary heroes on a courageous rescue mission. A story where heroes are found in the most unlikely places.
T-minus 3 minutes to launch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and blast off.
Name's Sputnik.
Can I hitch a ride home with you guys?
For shizzle, dog.
This is my last chance to go home to my boy Sasha.
We're lost in space, dog. Whoa!
Oh, we're going to the moon.
All the blue cheese a fella can eat.
Are you ready to go for the walk of your lives?
Feather. How are we gonna get home this time?
Space Buddies, an all-new movie coming soon to Disney DVD and Blu-ray High Def.
Don't pull his paw!
The movie you're watching right now is magic. And the magic continues after the credits. Just look inside your DVD or Blu-ray disc for the magic code to start earning points toward fantastic rewards at DisneyMovieRewards.com.
Have you ever wondered?
Welcome to Pixie Hollow.
Tinkerbell is one of the greatest characters created by Walt Disney. And I always wondered, where did Tinkerbell come from?
When we were talking about what this first movie about Tinkerbell should be about, it seemed natural to do an origin story. How did Tinkerbell come to be? What is her world like?
Creating Pixie Hollow was a very awe-inspiring experience, delving into the world that really, where nobody has really gone before.
We wanted to explore this fantastic world through the perspective of Tinkerbell as she sees it for the first time.
Oh, it's incredible.
And discovers all the amazing and fascinating things that are going on there.
When the moon comes up to shine her face.
We have an enormously talented team of artists that all put their heads together to create the world of Pixie Hollow.
Then.
It's Tinkerbell, you snail brain.
So pretty.
Tinkerbell is one of Walt Disney's most iconic characters of all time.
Thank you.
So creating this movie was a huge responsibility. Every detail, every step along the way was taken with such care and pride for Peter Pan that came before us.
To the air, fairies! To the air!
There's been a good bit of research done into fairies and their world. I'm going back to, of course, J.M. Barrie, who we consider to be one of the foremost researchers in the field of fairies.
Well, we drew from J.M. Barrie's Peter Pan. We drew from Walt Disney's Peter Pan. And we also drew from the Realm of the Never Fairies to create the world of Pixie Hollow.
Just a little bit of pixie dust.
Peter Pan, the original Walt Disney animated film, was our starting point because we wanted to make sure there was a sense of continuity into the look of the two films, of Tinkerbell and Peter Pan. In fact, the first time we see Neverland in Tinkerbell, it's a reproduction in CG of the first time Peter Pan and Wendy see Neverland in Peter Pan.
Oh, Peter, it's just as I've always dreamed it would be.
We always wanted to make you aware when you're in Pixie Hollow that you're in Neverland as well. So those mountains are always the backdrop of any of the shots that are in Pixie Hollow. One of the other major influences was Albert Bierstadt, who was a painter around the 1860s, who went west and painted places like Yosemite and the Sierras before anyone was out here from the east. And he painted visions of those places in a way that was magical and romantic and almost otherworldly.
We really assembled an amazing group of artists to come up with this great mythology about what fairies do and what they can lend to our world.
Fairies to the south, to the east and west.
When I first heard about the Tinkerbell Fairies project, it actually came from Disney Publishing. And they started describing Pixie Hollow, and I was so blown away by how they were connecting the fairies to nature. And I thought, this is the key to Tinkerbell and the world she came from.
We wanted to set up the world of Pixie Hollow and also support the idea that fairies bring the magic of nature to the world. So Jeff Howard, screenwriter, and myself worked with his team and also our incredible storyboard artists, and Janine Russell, our producer, and Fred Warder, our art director.
One of the most interesting ideas that came out of our whole brainstorming process was the idea that within Pixie Hollow, there are different realms for every season. And there's an area for spring where it's always warm and temperate in springtime. There's an area for summer. There's an area for fall. Then there's the winter woods where it's always snowy there.
The world of Pixie Hollow is centered around pixie dust. The pixie dust tree is the center point of the world. That's the key visual image of Tinkerbell.
The pixie dust is the sap of the tree. And the idea was that the roots of the pixie dust tree spread out to all the different corners of Pixie Hollow, so the Pixie Hollow itself is really infused with the magic of pixie dust.
The wonderful thing about designing Pixie Hollow was that we were able to look at everyday objects in nature from a different perspective.
One of the most fun parts of coming up with what Pixie Hollow looked like was working with scale and how everything would relate to a fairy that's, you know, 5.5, 6 inches tall. We tried to go down to the fairy's perspective.
We call it fairy cam when we were designing the movie and getting really down, really low with the fairies and really seeing how they would see it within their eyes.
I would get my camera down on the ground and shoot photographs, and sometimes if it seemed really real, like it could have been made by a fairy, I tried to carefully bring it back with me to the office to have as inspiration. I constantly urged the artist to go out into nature, to take hikes, and to go out with the idea that if you were 5.5 inches to 6 inches tall,
because you're so tiny,
what would you use for clothing? How would you make tools? How would you create a shelter out of leaves and things that you would find in a forest or on the beach? And it just really opens up your eyes.
Janine brought in a little seed pod that almost looked like a little bowl.
Slow down, cheese! I can't keep up!
Watch out for falling!
Watch out for falling maple seeds!
John Lasseter actually brought in those little maple seeds that spin down from the trees. And so we ended up using those for fairy ceiling fans, and we also used them to sort of drop things from tops of trees.
All of us started to bring in these objects to work with us, like, wow, look what I found over the weekend. It's just a whole different way of looking at our world and then creating a world for fairies.
You've arrived at a most glorious time.
It was so much fun to come up with the ideas of what fairy homes look like. So to use the idea of scale and also to use the idea of nature and drawing things from nature, their rooftops could be made of leaves and their doors could be made of the top of a pumpkin with a little stem, using little seashells and mushrooms and acorns. And there's all kinds of things within nature that create a fairy home.
The architecture was inspired to a great extent by indigenous cultures around the world and how they would use building materials within their environment. And it makes those buildings feel very much a part of their environment.
When you first start talking about the designs of the costumes, John Lasseter said, these costumes should be designed around things that you see in nature.
So all we really had to do was look around in nature and find the beauty in a rose petal or the beauty in the color of the ocean. And that really helped to inspire the clothing for these fairies.
The character designers would just pull flowers apart and place them on dolls and try to find the most organic way to have that flower wrap around a character so that it felt very natural but also very beautiful and helped the character to feel like they were a part of nature at all times.
They use leaves and they use flower petals and they use all kinds of things that are of their scale to create their clothing.
I'll get to apply my artistic sensibility.
Rosetta, the garden fairy, actually has an upside down rose as her dress.
The last light of day. It's the richest kind of all.
And Iridesa, our light fairy, she's wearing sunflower petals. So that gives you scale and it's just a lot more magical.
Most of us walk through life and we don't maybe see what's really around us. And I think all of us need to kind of get down on our picnic blankets next time we go to the park and really look around us to see that scale and what world exists down below.
Hi there!
After working on this movie, I'll never see the world the same. And whenever you're walking down the street, you see grass growing between the cracks of the sidewalk, and you wonder if a fairy is the one who pulled that grass up. It just makes you look at the world differently, makes you love nature.
700 years into the future, mankind will leave our planet, leaving Earth's cleanup in the hands of one incredible machine. His name is Wally. After all these years, he's developed one little glitch.
What?
A personality. He's extremely curious. And just a little bit lonely. But all that is about to change.
It all began when one little mermaid dreamed of life on the land. Now the incredible tale continues as Ariel's daughter,
Melody Child,
dreams of life in the sea.
You know what? Sometimes I even pretend I have fins.
The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea. New special edition. Experience a story unlike any other.
Melody can't know about merpeople or Atlantica.
Oh, this is delicious.
Return to the mystery.
Melody's gone! Melody's gone!
I should have known I couldn't keep Melody from the sea. It's time I trusted her with the truth.
Return to the magic.
Your destiny awaits you.
I'm a mermaid!
Return to the adventure.
What's happening?
The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea. Coming soon to new special edition Disney DVD. Only for a limited time.
You're a mermaid?
Presents.
Is the lake this way?
The incredible story of a young boy who meets a magical friend.
Presenting Bailey!
Bailey?
Oh, we have a winner!
So you want me to believe that I can have whatever I ask for?
What do you say? You want to have a try?
I want fish.
I bring from the depths to fly like wind! Combo seafood platter number 3 is made to order. Make a choice.
I'll take this.
Say no more.
That's so cool.
All right. So from now on, you are officially my one and only master.
Climb aboard.
Hold on, master.
Here we go.
On a journey where wishes come true.
See one that you like?
I like all of them.
Get ready to march.
Get ready to run.
Huh?
And featuring the voice talents of High School Musical's Corbin Bleu.
Need a ticket, Raymond.
Okay, get in, get in. The world will spin. And don't forget your popcorn tin. Wow, master can act. No, I didn't help. You must have done it on your own.
Yeah!
Discover the magic that comes from within. The Secret of the Magic Gourd, an all-new movie coming soon to Disney DVD.
These products not yet rated. New from Disney DVD Games, High School Musical and Hannah Montana. Don't just sit there. Take center stage and become a rock star with Hannah Montana. And go to the head of the class with High School Musical. Including two new songs from High School Musical 3. They're new from Disney DVD Games. High School Musical DVD Game and Hannah Montana DVD Game. Look for them in the DVD section.
Enter the online world of fairies, a magical place where you can become a fairy and fly into Pixie Hollow. A place where you can make tons of friends and play fun fairy games. Where you can show off your fairy style with amazing fashions and decorate your Pixie Perfect home. So take flight and join your fairy friends for an experience like never before. Play now at PixieHollow.com.
Every day, watch Disney Channel's original series, Wizards of Waverly Place. Ever want to be in two places at the same time?
Expelliarmus!
Ever want your sister to do what you tell her?
Faster, faster, faster!
In a family of wizards.
Animata.
Anything is possible.
Let me get my sweater.
Cashmere's Epirus.
Ooh, soft.
Disney Channel's original series, Wizards of Waverly Place. Every day.
On Disney Channel.
There is a place where you get to dive right in. And it's your dance, too. Where you really are a princess or a pirate. And Tinkerbell flies before your very eyes. There is a place where dreams come true. Disney Parks.
Guide to Pixie Hollow. As a new fairy, you'll need to be familiar with the different parts of the hollow, and Queen Clarion said I could tell you about a few.
Yes, Tinkerbell, and I'll be joining you.
Oh, I hope I don't mess up anything. Maybe I should have spent a little more time looking at the guide. Well, you get to pick the area you want to see first. Go ahead. Of the Pixie Dust Tree, where every fairy first arrives, remember? The Pixie Dust Tree is the largest tree we have, You can see it from every corner in Pixie Hollow. Queen Clarion lives there.
And so do the ministers of the seasons.
I know. Well, at least I do now.
Why don't you explain what they do?
I can do that. Oh, now? Well, I guess I could.
Oh, Tinkerbell. Each minister is responsible for ensuring that their season comes and goes in an orderly fashion.
Oh, right. Now let's see the pixie dust well. Without your daily cup full of pixie dust, fairies can only fly a little way at a time.
But fairies use pixie dust for much more than flying. Right, Tinkerbell?
Sure, there are hundreds of uses. Garden fairies use it to give leaves an extra gleam. Animal fairies use it to wake a sleepy animal. And tinkers use it as grease, filler, and even glue. Now I'll show you Havendish Stream. And look, there's Tinker's Nook. That's where I live and work, at least when I'm not showing new fairies the magical guide. Havendish Stream. Sometimes lost things wash up on the banks. This is also where Terrence and I race leaf boats and play games. Look, they're playing fairy tag.
Tinkerbell, is that all you're going to share about Havendish Stream?
Of course not. I was just going to tell them about...
Perhaps water fairies?
Water fairies, right. They do all this really neat stuff with water, like make fountains and waterfalls.
Sometimes they even glide across the water behind hummingbirds for fun, or float downstream on lily pads.
They make their homes out of lily pads, too, and other water plants.
But even though water is a most important element to our work, a fairy's wings must be completely dry in order to fly. Right, Tinkerbell?
Good point, Queen Clarion.
And because fairy wings are so delicate, wing-washing fairies are assigned to carefully do just that.
Plus, it's really tough to wash your own wings, believe me.
And no two sets of fairy wings are exactly alike.
Just like snowflakes. Okay, back to the map. Uh-oh, I think I went too far.
I'm afraid you did, Tinkerbell. You went all the way to autumn, and we haven't the time to explore other seasons today.
Right, Queen Clarion. Let me try this again. There's a lot to discover there. Good choice. This is Springtime Square, one of the most popular spots in all of Spring Valley. We hold special events and festivals there. And look, the music fairies are practicing. There's the Everblossom. It'll be opening soon, and spring will begin.
Other plants are also raised here in Springtime Square, such as saplings and baby flower bulbs.
Hey, little fella. Are you looking for an animal fairy to help you? I do it myself, but I've learned to leave it to the experts. Animal fairies care for all the woodland animals. They even help keep their coats shiny and their teeth clean. Right, Queen Clarion?
That's right.
And they speak every animal's language, so they know if a critter needs a thorn removed from its paw or its tummy tickled just by talking to it.
Hawk.
Right. They're our enemies, so they don't speak to fairies.
Tinkerbell, a real hawk.
Oh, gotta fly. Oh, that was a close one. Choose that. It's great. A beautiful day in Sunflower Meadow. Those are fast-flying fairies, some of the rarest fairies in Pixie Hollow.
We count on their talents for a variety of things, including sensing changes in air currents and warning us of approaching storms.
Because we can't afford to lose months of hard work. Again. There are the garden fairies. They take care of everything that grows in the soil. And they make the prettiest homes out of the flowers and plants they grow.
Yes, and they artfully paint each leaf and flower petal of the spring garden with paints made from berry juices and a touch of pixie dust.
But but sometimes they don't make enough. If you see a speckled leaf in the garden, it means the garden fairies ran out of paint.
Oh, Tinkerbell, a speckled leaf merely indicates a fairy's unfinished work. Perhaps a human caught them off guard. Fairies take extra care not to be seen.
That's what I meant, pretty much. Hey, look over there. Queen Clarion, what are those?
Trolls. They often hide under that bridge. And trolls are not friendly to fairies.
Oh.
You must be cautious that you're never seen.
Oh, I'm glad you told me. Well, those are the only pages of the magical guide I can show you today. But you can revisit any area by choosing it again. Wait! Wait! I forgot to tell you about the light fairies. Queen Clarion, what should I do?
Perhaps I can help.
But it's nighttime. Isn't it too late now?
Tinkerbell, when are the light fairies' talents most amazing?
Nighttime? Of course! What a great idea, Queen Clarion!
Yes! What better time to demonstrate the light fairies' amazing abilities to bend and shape light?
A rare talent indeed. Well, come back soon, and I'll be happy to show you the magical guide again. I'll see you around Pixie Hollow. Bye-bye!
Everywhere you go.
Very well.
Sparkles.
What do we do now? They never taught us this part. Do we fly straight in? Do we close our eyes? Give a password? What if there's a password?
Is this gonna mess up my hair?
Come on, Slowpoke. Last one on the other side.
Today is the day you become a garden fairy.
It's so beautiful.
Come on. Good luck, Tink.
You can do it.
Time to get pollinized.
What?
I don't know.
So what do I do?
Well, some of these little darlings are a little bit shy and need just a touch of encouragement to blossom to their full potential. Thank you, Sugar. But really, it's as easy as being beautiful. Yeah!
Right, Rose!
Talk about flower power!
You sure have the tulip touch!
Okay, Tink, show them what you got! Try coaxing her out, Tinkerbell. Flattery will get you everywhere.
Okay, hello there, darling flower. Oh, tickle, tickle, tickle. Come on now. Everyone wants to see your beautiful face.
I'm all right.
Oh,
Gesundheit. Okay, now stop. Hey, where are you going? Now you stay put.
Have you seen her?
Afraid not, Orange Blossom.
Clank and Bobble haven't seen her either.
Hey, have you guys seen
her? No. I hope Tink's not too mad at us. Tink can't change her talent.
If she's still angry, she only has herself to blame. Why doesn't she just stick to being a tinker?
She just wants to go to the mainland, Des. And we said we'd help her.
Yeah, well, you shouldn't have promised her that, Syl.
Girls, enough. Now, Tink may drive us a little crazy, but I think we all just want what's best for her. I just wish she could see what a rare talent she is.
Yeah, I mean, what we saw her doing, I've never seen anyone do anything as amazing as that, even Vidia.
Well, Vidia is a rare talent, too, but with one big difference. Tink's not a complete stinkweed. Hey, I'm still missing one. There you are.
I'm not here.
It's Vidia.
Then I'm definitely not here.
I need to talk to you, Tinkerbell.
Jeez, of all the times. What do you want?
You got a little something. Tink, I want to apologize.
Huh?
I've been thinking, and I understand why you're doing what you're doing. I get it now. And I'm sorry. I've been so snippy.
Oh. Okay.
And also, I just hate to see you let your friends down.
Let them what? How?
Well, you have to admit you've been a good bit of trouble for them. And all they've done is try to help you. But I bet I know how you can make it up to them. Corral the sprinting thistles.
Sprinting thistles? No. Oh, no, 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 no.
Think about it. They're a huge nuisance to everyone, especially when we're getting ready for spring. You would be a hero. Plus, it would show Queen Clarion you're just as worthy as any of us to go to the mainland. And spring starts tomorrow. This might be your last chance. You do still want to go, don't you?
Well, yeah, I...
So? Get back in there.
Hey, wait a sec.
Tinkerbell, you have to come back.
You're the only one who can make spring happen on time.
How? What are you guys talking about?
These.
If you could make more and show us how to use them.
Maybe we can make spring happen on time. I can't.
What? But Tink!
You guys, this stuff never worked. It's just junk.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. Fairy Mary was right. Queen Clarion was right. Even Vidia was right. I'm the useless fairy. And the last thing Pixie Hollow needs is a fairy like me.
We'll never give up on you, Sugar Plum. Don't give up on yourself.
I'm sorry. You'll have to do it without me.
I hope you change your mind.